Whoa!
Oh, you see that flash behind it?
Bloody oath, he was a big fish.
Come on, big crab in there.
Bloody hit, mate.
Look at that. Choice.
Give me a big jandle. Oh no, sorry, me thong.
Well, this is my fourth visit to tropical far north Queensland. All the other times I've been here, I've been brought here by a giant black marlin. But this time, we've got our own Land Cruiser, we've got our own Staby craft, we've loaded up all of our gear, and we're hitting the road for a 1,200 kilometre road trip where we don't know the locals, we don't know the wildlife, except we've heard that there's croc feeding season, we don't know the rivers, we don't know the roads, but I do know that with a plan like that, we're bound to find some adventure.
Oh, yeah. Alright.
How did that sound for an intro?
Sounds pretty good.
I don't think I could make that sound any more exciting, because it is going to be that good. Let's go, guys. Come on, dudes, man, I'm amped. Right, Tinaroo. Actually, is it this way? I just want to get there before dark. We've got to get there before dark, because apparently these big bearers bite.
We're on the road in tropical North Queensland. Starting in Cairns, we're heading north to explore all of the fishing, from the deep sea to the Great Barrier Reef, to the coast, up the estuaries, and even the rivers, lakes, and billabongs. Along with me and Jake are the runners-up from our fishing apprentice competition, Danny and Nikki. Together, we're all set to have some entirely new fishing experiences.
Yo! Now I just got smashed, bro.
The Aussies rave about the barramundi, so we're starting by heading inland to Lake Tinaroo to find out what all the fuss is about.
Here we go, Tinaroo, barramundi heaven. Well, lucky we're in a landy. Well, this is it, guys. Lake Tinaroo. Now, I'm not much of a lake fisherman, and I'm definitely not a barra fisherman, given I've never caught a barramundi, but I was never going to catch one if I stayed at home. We've only got about an hour of daylight left. Well, this fella here looks like he knows what he's doing. Mark!
Buddy! Hey!
Sorry we're late, mate.
Mate, better late than ever.
I know. So, barramundi fishing, never caught one. You've caught plenty. What do you know about this lake?
Mate, not a great deal.
So is it
mate.
Your first time here as well?
Yeah, mate. Yeah.
Nothing like, and your accent doesn't sound terribly Australian.
Nah, from near London, mate.
It's from near London. Okay, so. See, a bit more planning on our itinerary. You know, we've come all this way to fish Lake Tinaroo for giant barra, and the guide's come from London and it's his first time as well. Anyway, never mind. I've got to go park the truck. We'll run out of light, eh? Oh, Jackie, my boy, we're here. It's funny, this morning, this very morning, this is quite surreal, we were in Auckland. And now we're in far north Queensland, in the back and beyond of nowhere, on a lake, about to go barra fishing for the first time. And looks like those guys have got a head start on us. Danny and Nikki off to show you up, Jake.
We'll see.
And so far they've got a head start on you in the fact that they actually remembered to bring their fishing rods this morning. Someone turned up at the airport without their fishing rod. Anyway, that's enough of that. We'll put it behind us, eh? Come on, let's go.
It's like a flooded forest up here. But we're not here for the scenery.
There's a little weed bed up on this point, Matt, and I reckon if we stand out a bit and just cast in and around that.
And like, so we'll just spot this barra, and I mean, like what sort of size?
Mate, these are proper barras.
And so if we catch one something skinny like this, with these bits of stick sticking around the place, what are our chances?
Just go steady with them, you'll be right. The harder you pull a barra, the harder they fight back.
Like a kingfish?
So you can trick them somewhat, you know, they start pulling, you just go with them, and they just stop, you know? But if you pull, they really lay into you.
I noticed when we were coming up, we got the old kill the motor. You've got to be quiet, do you?
Yeah, exactly. Because it's shallow, clear water, and these are spooky fish, you know, so.
So just to clarify, so you said this is clear water?
Well, yeah, but it's actually quite clear. Barra being barra, they won't be far away. They're lazy buggers, eh?
There we go. We're going to go and anchor up, quietly albeit, and cast some lures. Oh, he's got a little electric motor. This is stealthy. This is different, mate.
Big difference with barra fishing, eh?
Oh, mate, stealth, yeah. Just to creep up and you're manoeuvrable, you know? And for these kind of barra, makes all the difference, doesn't it?
How's the serenity? Nothing like Bonnie Doon.
There's a good fish, look. A lot of the time, watch your line. These barrel hit it as it's just sinking down.
Oh, a boil right on my lure. Came and swirled right on it. Didn't seem like a very big fish though. Did you hear it? Oh, that's when I wasn't looking.
They're ambushes, so they don't chase their prey. So they just sort of sit and wait in camouflage, waiting for things to go past them.
It's pretty, isn't it?
It is pretty. But we ain't a scenery show, are we, boys? So, we're probably going to leave you about now, because this is as much as I can talk about scenery. We'll see you early in the morning. Some bent rods and screaming reels.
Whoa!
Oh,
did you see that
flash behind? Bloody oath, he was a big fish.
Come on, big crab in there.
Look at that.
Choice!
Give me me jandle. Oh no, sorry, me thong.
We hope you're enjoying this classic episode, but if you'd like to see our latest content, action, tips, and how-to videos, you can get it all on the Ultimate Fishing app, available now at the App Store, Google Play, or by visiting ultimatefishing.tv.
Bonus fillet right there.
We're back out on Lake Tinaroo again this morning, 5:30 a.m. It's warm, still, and we're hunting the elusive barramundi. I'm not even sure if these barramundi exist. It could be something the Aussies made up. Might be like an Australian tunnifer.
Whoa! Did you see that flash behind?
That was a big fish.
Bloody oath, he was a big fish. Big fish, eh? Bugger. But never mind. Oh, well, keep trying, mate.
So far, the barramundi is remaining fairly elusive, and it's a shame because it's high on my list. I've actually taken a leaf out of my kids' books. When we go away on holiday or go out fishing, they actually write a list for me of the fish I've got to help them catch. So I've done the same. And you'll see there, barramundi, no tick yet. Hopefully this will be full within the next few days.
We've adopted Mark's stealth approach, so we're approaching the snags by paddle to give us one last shot at a big barramundi.
Yeah, there's a shot. That was a bite. That was definitely a bite. Oh, come on. First bit of Aussie wildlife. Yeah. Mean, we just seen a snake. Woohoo! Oh, there is a head out of the water. Mean. Snakeage. Any bites?
You guys?
Yeah, I had one.
Yeah, we saw one fish in the weeds there. One good fish.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
We've seen a couple of snakes.
You have?
Yeah.
Cool.
We thought it might have been a barramundi. Are they long and skinny and do they swim like that?
Pretty though, isn't it?
Oh, mate, stunning. I might need to get into the salty stuff because I can't catch fish in fresh water.
Not your thing, eh?
I'm hopeless at it, mate. Well, Mark, Tinaroo, great place.
Tough water, eh?
Yeah, well, I've always struggled on fresh water, but I'm off after some salty stuff. Which way to Port Douglas?
Right. Head down to Mareeba, 2 hours that way, and you'll be there.
Okay, the road trip continues, and we are going to see what a barramundi looks like, are we?
Don't you worry.
You beauty.
You have a good trip down there, guys.
Okay, mate. We'll see you in Cooktown.
we'll have to wait till later in our trip to catch up with the elusive barramundi, because right now we're heading for the salt water of the tropical North Queensland coast.
Oh yes, back in the salty stuff. And where we are right now is Port Douglas. It's a beautiful seaside resort town, but it's also gateway to the Great Barrier Reef and all the fishing adventures that lie beyond. So guys, where we're going right now, we're likely to be able to catch bluefin trevally, golden trevally, giant trevally, dogtooth tuna, sailfish, marlin, and just not any marlin, giant black marlin. There's tiger sharks. In fact, there's just about every shark you can speak of. And then there's all the hundreds of reef species. And we're here already. Well, at least we're hitching a ride anyway. Barry.
Hey guys, hey Matty.
How are you, mate?
Got a mermaid here with you.
Mermaid with us, oh yes. We're chucking the Staby craft up on top and we're heading to the outer ribbon reefs. And if I don't look excited, I am, because I know just how good it is out there and I can't wait to show these guys. Come on, let's get this thing up.
Don't get under it, guys.
Well, here it is. The top of the Doreen 2 is the new home of our little baby Staby craft. We've got to have a name for our boat too. The Little Dingo.
Yeah, the
Little Dingo it is. Right, we've just got one wee little mission to do here in Port Douglas before we depart out to the Great Barrier Reef. So we've relaunched the Little Dingo and we're going mud crabbing with Tim, because Tim knows how to get mud crabs. I don't, but I know how to eat them. Dude was just telling us there's a croc up there.
There is. Pretty much now, every cockpit in the water.
Okay.
In the water, feel like water.
Oh, of course.
Saltwater crocodiles are something we have to be aware of in these estuarine waters. Right now, during breeding season, they can be very territorial. And Tim points out a float, still bearing the scars from a recent attack from a saltwater croc.
Crocs. Just randomly chewing on floats. Yeah! Oh, you're a jumpy there, boy. What's happening here is because these mud crabs are so sought after, that it's actually hidden. He's thrown the gaff out and hooked the pot, which has been hidden up in the estuary. Come on, big crab in there. Someone moving in there. Oh yeah.
He's had a bit of a tough life. He's got a
hole. Oh yeah, he's got a hole in him. So you just grab him by the bum, yeah?
Yeah mate, there's only one way to get him.
There's only one way?
Yeah, otherwise when they get you they don't.
I can't imagine it would end real good, eh?
Yeah, he's got some war wounds, he's had a big chomp, yeah. Probably maybe a croc. Crocs get
a croc?
A croc will get hold of him.
What are the chances of seeing a croc?
Yeah, further up the creek definitely. But yeah, you can see if you hold him anywhere behind this line,
yeah,
can't bite you, and you can't get you anywhere in front.
Whereabouts you hold a croc so it can't bite you?
No, you don't play with him.
No, you don't.
So he's 15 centimetres across from spike to spike.
Oh, so there's a size limit?
Size limit, yeah.
Yeah.
In Queensland we can't keep female crabs, it's only male.
So we just reset this thing and let it carry on doing its thing.
Yeah, can't pick the next one up and see how we go.
Beauty.
Oh, there's one there.
There's one in there?
Yeah.
Oh,
there's a few.
Sweet, right. Okay, now it's your fellow's turn to get him out now.
Hands have got to be behind the crab. We can't lose any fingers.
Good boys.
Boy.
Look at that.
Look at that.
Choice.
You want to grab one, mate? You want to grab one, Jay?
Yeah.
Oh, we got one on the deck.
Go on for you, man.
Go on, get in on there, my son. Oh, you pull his legs off. Now you just made him mad.
Ooh, he's fired up.
I'll leave him for you. I'll go for the big one, I think.
All right. It's all in.
I don't want to piss this one off by pulling his legs off, though. That's the... And do they know when you touch them in the wrong spot that they can get you?
Oh yeah.
Okay. Touch them in the wrong spot then.
This is great.
Oh yeah.
Right. Okay, keep him all. He's big.
This is definitely bigger than my crabs.
Alright, we've got a couple more.
his claw. That's his defence, so he'll come in and attack him. He'll lock on, the claw will hold, and then he'll throw his claw, and the claw will keep him pressing. It's like inside, oh, hydraulics inside.
Bit of female.
So if one latched onto you and you snap the claw off, too bad. It's just going to keep biting you.
So what you got to do, you got to break his shell and release the fluid, because it'll just keep compressing.
Hydraulics, amazing.
Hydraulics, yeah.
I tell you what, nature never ceases to amaze me.
He'll grow his claw back within, say, four weeks. His claw will start to regrow from the shell. So yeah, pretty amazing creature.
Give me jandle. Oh no, sorry, me thong.
If you hold her over the side, hold your thong up and hold her over, and she'll just drop the claw.
Oh, will she?
Yep. She'll pretty much.
We're gonna let her go. Yeah, she's female.
Amazing!
And there we go, and that'll keep just chomping through that thong.
That'll just keep going, and so we have to smash that open to let the hydraulic fluid out.
See the fluid here?
It's still flexing.
And you'll see it pumping. Just keep pumping.
You would not want that to be your finger.
Oh well. So what you're saying is I'm not getting it off. I've got to wait till it rots off.
I'm not going to be very popular.
Stop, pull us back.
It's heavy,
mate. Oh, they're supposed to do that.
Crap. Oh, and a fish. Hey, you know, that's the first fish we've caught in bloody Aussie on this trip.
He's a gold spot cod.
Gold spot cod.
Yep.
Hang on, mate, I'll just check and see if that's on my list. Nah, no gold spot cod.
Watch out for this guy.
Watch out for the poisonous spines there, mate.
He'll probably give you more damage than the mud crab.
Yeah, and they shoot lasers out of their eyes.
Do they?
Yeah, mate, everything in Aussie kills you, you know.
They fight bloody. Like stink, don't they? Look at him. Little razor sharp teeth. Spikes all over him. Wicked camo. Oh, you got me a couple of times, so that's it. Look at that. First little bit of damage for the trip.
That's our way.
Gotta get him quick, eh?
Gotta get him quick.
Female, eh?
Yep.
She is fired up. She's going home.
Beautiful.
Alright. She's muddy business, this one.
It is muddy business.
Don't call it clean crabbing. They call it mud crabbing. Rightio then, boys. That was a very worthwhile mission. Mud crabs.
Something different.
Chili crab for dinner, mate. And then off to the GBR. That's like the cool name for the Great Barrier Reef. The motor just stalled, and here we thought we were just trapped for the night in croc heaven. And we've come, how many miles up the creek would we be?
Oh mate, it'd have to be two.
2 miles up the creek, running the whole way, and we've just stopped, and we've looked that we've been running the whole time on just the fuel that was in the line. If that's not an endorsement on how these E-Techs are lean on fuel, nothing is. Jeez mate, that's impressive, eh?
That is impressive.
Look at the new tank, you would change
from over and took it on.
Coming back to impress the woman folk back at port.
How you like those crabs, girls? Dinner's up.
With a bucket full of tasty mud crabs secured for dinner, we then set sail and travel right through the night to the far reaches of the Great Barrier Reef. In the morning, we'll be launching our Staby craft to fish amongst the coral reef system. But as the day dawns, Jake and cameraman Dave have taken the opportunity to drop a line from the Doreen Tip.
Love the technique, Jackie boy.
Are you taking it, mate?
Oh, I have no idea. I can tell you that it's probably not a snapper, though.
Yeah, coral trout.
Right on, Jackie.
Sweet action. Not as big as the cameraman's one, so I've definitely got to beat his. I'll hold it as far as I can.
Beautiful fish. Jake's got a smaller model.
First Aussie fish. A bit smaller than Tug's, but
okay.
That's right, he's got a
to a closer now, guys, a closer. Come on.
Almonds and upwards from these fish. I think we're going to go for a GT or maybe something even nastier later this afternoon.
Oh, pretty.
Yeah, pretty, eh? But it's like anything pretty, it hurts just that little bit in here when you lose it.
Oh, it's got a bite.
Yeah, it's a fish. Hopefully got him away from that sharp coral. Oh, he's gone straight to ground with me new lure. That didn't take long, did it?
That's what they do.
Oh, mate. Straight to ground. Yeah, they ate it though, didn't they? My first waxwing lure has been donated to the reef.
Fish one.
Matty zip.
Next up, we battle some tough conditions and even tougher fish from our little staby craft.
Yo! Now I just got smashed, bro.
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode. But if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.